Nikum class, how are you all? I hope so you all are fine. Today's the topic of our lecture is suitable methods for the collection of the gases. First of all, the thing that we have to keep in mind that the methods depend upon the factors. And what are those factors? The first one is solubility. And the second one is density, means to know about like the gases which we are going to collect, whether they are soluble in water or not, means its ability to dissolve in water. The next comes density, how much they are denser, means more dense than air or less dense than air, means we are comparing it with in the case of density with air and in the case of solubility with water. There are basically three common methods that we use to collect the gases. The first one, displacement of water, upwards delivery and downwards delivery. Now, the first one, displacement of water. The next, basically they are also these two, the next second and the third one, they are also called as the displacement by air. The first one, displacement of water, what does it mean? Like, we can use this method for the gases whose nature is, mean they are insoluble in water or slightly soluble in water. Along with the solubility, what about the density? That they are lighter in density than water, means this is what we are using the displacement of water for the gases like hydrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide. When the reactant reacts, the gas will produce and we can easily collect there. Due to the insolubility in water, they are unable to dissolve in water. Second thing, they are lighter, their density is lighter than water, so they can easily collect in this way upward. They are lighter, so they will move upward. The next one is upwards delivery. This method is basically used to collect the gases which are soluble in water and they has a lighter density as compared to the air, means they are soluble in water. We cannot use the method displacement of water for them. So the gases like ammonia, this is the only one example, like we can collect mostly for ammonia, we are using upwards delivery. You can see over here, like the gas produced due to the lighter in weight, they will move or try to move upward in the gas jar. So here we can collect the gas ammonia easily. Next, downwards delivery. This method is used to collect the gases which are soluble in water and have heavier density as compared to the air. If they are soluble in water, we cannot use the displacement of water because they can be easily soluble in water. The examples are chlorine, hydrochloric acid and sulfur dioxide. Along with the poisonous gases, we basically use the fume cupboard to collect the gases. Due to solubility of water, we cannot use displacement of water. And if we will talk about the density, they are heavier. So this method we can use for the gases who are heavier or they are more dense as compared to the air. The gas, as due to the heavier density, they will try to move downward. So that's why we are using the downwards delivery. Even like the diagram, it's indicated or it's basically derived from the name as well. The downwards delivery means the gases which can move downward. There are some of the examples of the gases like ammonia, carbon dioxide, chlorine, hydrogen, hydrogen chloride and oxygen. Like ammonia, lighter. If they are lighter, so they will try to move upward. Which method we will use? Upwards delivery, and they are extremely soluble, so we cannot use for it displacement of water. In the same way, carbon dioxide, heavier, they will try to move downward. We will use downward delivery method, and they are slightly soluble. Again, we cannot use for it displacement of water. In the same way, the other examples are given. Drying of the gas sample. How we can dry these gases? Basically, we are using the different drying agents like concentrated sulfuric acid, quicklime, calcium oxide, which are also called, then fused calcium chloride, also called as heated calcium chloride. This is what we will enter the moist HCl, the moist gases from the one side along with the test tube. Keep in mind that this test tube from where we are entering the gas, that must be inserted in the drying agents. It must not be above the drying agent. it must be inserted in the drying agent. So after passing this moist HCl gas, after passing this drying agent, it will easily like evolve over here and can be can easily be collected from this test tube, can easily be go outside. The next one, dry ammonia. This is what the quicklime is acting over here as a drying agent. We will enter the moist ammonia from here. It will, after passing from the drying agent, can easily be collect the dry ammonia gas. Moist hydrogen, after passing from the fused calcium chloride, it can easily be collected over here, the dry hydrogen gas. The measurement of the volume of the gas sample. The next thing is, if we are collecting these gases, the next thing, how much, the quantity, the amount, the volume. So this is called as the measurement. We have to measure the volume of that gas. So we can measure by using the gas syringe. By using the gas syringe, we can measure the volume of the gas. What will be the procedure? This one, at the start of the experiment, the plunger will be, you can see over here, all the gases we will expel from it by pressing this plunger. After the collection of gases, you can see here, as the gas will enter from the syringe, it will, the plunger will move backward direction. So that was all about the today's topic, that was the collection of gases.